common question that graduate students have about electronic theses, dissertations and reports, or ETDRs, is why templates should be used. They ask what advantages templates actually provide. ETDRs are created by graduate students around the world. To keep them as accessible as possible, students generally use a common set of templates or forms from Word or from LaTeX to ensure that all basic elements of an ETDR are present. The title pages, the abstracts, the navigable table of contents, list of figures, list of tables, a references list, and other elements. The elements required vary based on whether the document is a thesis, a dissertation, or a report. Some ETDRs differ in formatting based on the particular domain or discipline. The Word template for the doctoral dissertation begins with a README section, as do actually all three of the templates. Here you've got a title page with placeholder text, and then contents for the abstract, and so forth. So all ETDR templates have the following basic elements: placeholder text and other elements to ensure that required information is included. These also ensure that the included information goes in the proper format. So when we talk about format, when I click on any particular text or object inside the template, there's a particular style that is shown in the styles pane. So within the template, you have a lot of back-end coding that enables certain functionalities. The built-in table of contents, the list of figures, the list of tables where this gray field code is navigable. So you can actually hold down the control and you can click and jump right to that particular content. And this is a functionality that carries over into the particular PDF ETDR that you ultimately put out. There is also, as you'll notice, built-in pagination. So lowercase Roman numeral numbers for part of the prefatory materials, natural numbers beginning at page one and running in a chronological order throughout for the rest of the pagination. These are the basic elements that have to still function by the time you have put your contents into the template. So the pagination has to be correct, the style of the text has to be correct, the navigation has to work, visual images, any maps, any photographs, diagrams, and so on have to be fairly high res or high resolution, about 350 dots per inch or pixels per inch for any of the visuals. And so once your dissertation meets those requirements, then generally it will pass muster in terms of the formatting side. Of course, you're gonna have to defend and make sure the research passes muster with the committee. Also, so the templates do not have any built-in source citation method. They are what is called agnostic, okay? So let's go ahead and scroll down. When we look at the, in this template, when we look at the references or bibliography list, which would be these here at the bottom of page 9 and the top of page 10, the templates do not have any built-in research source citation method. Whatever source citation method the student uses in that discipline is what should be used, right? So, and the research source citation method does not only define how the references or bibliography list goes, but also what in-text citation looks like. It actually also defines the captioning for any of the figures and the tables and what those should look like. So students should really review the standards that they are using for their citation methods. It is generally, if students use an online bibliography tool, at the top of Word, you will have some tab that can link you to that tool. And so those should be used attentively so that no mistakes are introduced into your work with the bibliography tool. If you use footnotes, no problem. Those go in great on the template. One piece of advice, if students receive a template from a friend or a colleague, it's generally not a good idea to just inherit a template that is floating around. It might be older, it might already have some broken code, and so any problems that ride with inherited templates will end up in the student's template. And there are ways to break these so that they are not usable. In which case, if that does happen, you just have to download a new template and re-put the contents in again. So I will go ahead and also give you all a fast look at what the LaTeX template looks like. So this is the LaTeX template as hosted in Overleaf, which is, I'm using it at the free version. And what you see here is you see the various tech files, the figures folder, where the digital images go here to the left. Basically, the one file in general that you'll be editing is the ETDR template.tech file. The code is in this left window where the percentage signs are, is where we have commented out directions for how to use this template. We are looking at the preamble or the early part of the tech file. We have various elements that are a part of this. The ETDR in LaTeX is a composite. It can be the master's thesis, it can be the doctoral dissertation, it can be the master's report, depending on what parts you activate and use. In the preamble, so we define the document class for this document. We load the packages that are used to enable the mathematical and equation and other representations in this work. And then you have basic style code and so forth, right? And all the various sections that follow. So you basically want to leave code active and then put in your text contents. And then as you put in your contents, you want to recompile your code. And as you compile your code again, any errors that Overleaf finds, they will note and tell you basically how to correct it. And your PDF ETDR will look like this. And when it has been filled out and you have the parts that you need and it looks perfect and the pagination looks correct and the navigation is possible in the table of contents, you just click and download the PDF and test that PDF for all the functionality, for image resolution, pagination, and so on. And once that passes muster and passes muster with your faculty advisor and your committee and anyone else who needs to check off on that, then you can then submit to KREX and so on and to ProQuest. Now, students do often try to customize their template to their own taste. They might prefer particular types of fonts or so on. And it's better to make a list of what they want to change and then contact someone in IT to talk about the ETDR and so they can formally make the changes without breaking things. So please don't just highlight large chunks of your ETDR and manually make changes because that's a way to break your template. Students may use ETDR templates from the beginning of their studies, or they can use the templates anytime during their studies, or they can go and grab a template right at the end when they're just about ready to, you know, present their ETDR and to defend. Whenever is fine, as long as that is what serves the student. So we don't have any rules for that. And that generally at least tells you what templates are for and how they basically function.